Hey guys, during our trip to Pakistan, we visited Hunza Valley and the surrounding areas for 3 days. This video will provide a detailed account of all the places we visited and things that we have done in Hunza Valley. During our trip, we explored various locations ranging from less than 2,000 feet high with golden leaves to the snow-capped mountain at Khunjerab Pass with an elevation more than 4,700 meters. We interacted with the local people, visiting some of the historical landmarks, and witnessed some breathtaking landscapes. On day one, we stayed overnight at the Serena Hotel in Gilgit. After a restful night, we woke up early to witness the sunrise with the golden rays shine onto the snow-capped peaks from afar. Our first stop today was to visit the Gilgit Kargah Buddha. When we arrived, we had to walk a few minutes from where our coach stopped, pass a stream, and climb a few flights of stairs before reaching the viewpoint nearest to the Buddha carving. Took some photos at the platform, and some of us climbed up to the cliff to get a better angle for photos. There's a small hut before the stairs with an old grinding apparatus used by the ancient people to grind nuts to extract the oil and other things such as buckwheat, barley, and corn.
What are they grinding?
Mostly they were grinding buckwheat, wheat, barley, corn, and
this one.
After that, we walked back to our coach and saw some children staying nearby on the way. And they were a bit shy, but we convinced them to take photograph with us. Our next stop is the bazaar adjacent to the Gilgit River, where we can immerse ourselves in the local market culture. Our guide took us to buy some Himalaya salt. Accordingly, the salt is renowned for being the purest salt in the planet. Gilgit Market offers a variety of items for sale, including fresh produce such as vegetables and fruits, as well as some meat shops and household items. We also walked to the other side of the river via the new Gilgit Bridge.
This is Gilgit River. Cow is not.
Our next destination is where the continents collide. Nearly 55 million years ago, the Indian and Eurasian continental plate collides along a line that passed through this point. The tremendous pressure forced by the Earth's crust is buckled, producing the towering Karakoram mountain range. The Indian plate is still pushing off the Eurasian landmass at about 5 cm a year, that causing the mountains to rise about 7 millimeters annually. Not far away is a point where we could see the old Silk Road. This section of the visible road high up on the cliffside across the river evolved from a footpath into a pony track and was later widened into a jeep road from 1958 to 1960s. However, with the construction of the Karakoram Highway in the 1970s, the old Silk Road fell into disuse. Travel along the Karakoram Highway and stop at Rakaposhi Viewpoint Hotel for lunch. We truly enjoy our meal right in front of the Rakaposhi Mountain. After lunch, our guide Ali kindly invited us to his family, which was about only 20 meters away from the Rakaposhi Viewpoint. He had a huge apple tree in front of the courtyard, and we all enjoyed picking and eating the fresh apples. Grateful that Ali for allowing us to visit his family and where he stays and witness the typical village house in this region of Pakistan. After visiting his family, we head to Baltit Fort at Karimabad, Hunza. The fort is today's last destination before we stay overnight at the hilltop Hunza Hotel. After checking into the hotel, we strolled up the hill to Baltit Fort, passing through the Karimabad Bazaar. A tour guide at the fort explained to us various objects and took us on a tour, showing us the guard room, royal room, dungeons, the assembly hall, and many other places. Before sunset, we returned to Karimabad Bazaar to buy some souvenirs and nuts, and later we slept comfortably at the hilltop hotel. That's the mouse trap.
So now we are here 2500 meters. Okay.
The following day, we check out the hotel, drove on a highway, and stopped at a perfect viewpoint to witness the grandeur of the Lady's Fingers and Ota Peak. Also, we stop by whenever something is interesting, include the Ganesh rock carving with multiple language on the rocks along the Hunza River. And according to our guide, Marco Polo has been there before. This place is also part of the original Silk Road.
Different languages.
The water race all the way to this rock, and it's silty.
What's the name of this river?
Hunza River.
Hunza River.
Yeah, after Attabad, it naturally filters.
This is called Hunza Valley.
Hunza River.
Hunza Valley. You are traveling in Hunza Valley all the way to Khunjerab Pass.
Our coach went through a series of 5 tunnels to Attabad Lake. Attabad Lake was formed in January 2010 after a massive landslide in Attabad. The upper Hunza population was cut off and boats were the only means to communication until 2015 when a Karakoram highway was built. Attabad Lake offers a range of activities such as boating, jet skiing, fishing, etc. But due to our tight schedule, we did not participate in any activities. We were just instead taking some photos and enjoy the scenery. Look at it. Our next stop is the Hunza Suspension Bridge. This bridge is expected to be precarious and dangerous, with missing planks and strong winds that shake the bridge when we crossed. But today, we have a perfect weather with no wind, so we don't feel as it is as dangerous as most other people describe. Despite that, it was still a little nerve-wracking as we were still required to put on life jacket before we were allowed to walk on the bridge. Some of us walk halfway then come back, while others walk to the other side and take the zip line on the returning journey. During our journey towards Khunjerab Pass today, we stopped at the viewpoint at Passu to take some photos of the Passu Glacier. Then later, we have lunch at Kargah restaurant in a small town called Sost, where they serve us fresh naan soup and curries.
Inside the stove is boiling already. Wow!
Oh, there's a very nice tandoor you have. Nice tandoor, nice tandoor.
Wow!
And after lunch, we continue our road trip towards the Khunjerab Pass, the border between Pakistan and China. Located at the border of Pakistan and China, Khunjerab Pass is a nature wonder of rocky mountains and snow-capped surroundings. The National Bank of Pakistan is also home to the world's highest ATM here. Our coach had to stop at a certain distance from the border, so we had to walk towards it, and the thin air at high altitudes make it difficult for us to walk. Every step became heavier than the last, and we had to walk slowly and take frequent pauses as we often felt out of breath. After a long day of travel, we returned to the Hilltop Hotel for an overnight stay.
Today we're going to ride on this vintage jeep.
Our itinerary for day 3 differed from the usual, as we traveled by jeep instead of coach to reach the Hunza River and Nagar River confluence. Over there, we noticed some local people setting up tents by the river and searching for gold.
First river?
This one is Nagar River.
Nagar
it
River.
It has a number of, gold. The other river is Hunza River, sir.
So Hunza and Nagar, both rivers
yeah,
merged together.
Both rivers meeting here.
These nomads move from place to place. As we approached the tents, we could see families with children and babies living in them. The tents were their homes, and they did everything there. It seems unlikely that the children would attend school, and because they had already been part of the ghost searching team since they were young. We gave them some snacks, and they were happy to receive our chocolates. We also took a closer look at the living conditions. After our trip to the confluence, we make an impromptu stop at a scenic hilltop to capture the breathtaking view of the Golden Peak. Our guide thought adding this place to our itinerary would be a good idea, since we had some extra time before heading to the Hopper Glacier. And indeed, the best parts of the mountains and scenery of the autumn season in front of us was worth to detour.
The middle one.
Yes, 7,029 meters.
After lunch at the Hopper Inn for local cuisine, then we visited the nearby Hopper Glacier to see it up close. Although some of us were eager to look at the glacier closer, but they ultimately abandoned the idea due to the constraints of time. Our next stop after lunch was Altit Fort, which we'll visit before checking into Eagle Nest Hotel. It is also the oldest standing structure in Gilgit Bazaar region. The guide at the fort showed us around different areas such as the guard room, the king and queen bedroom, bathroom, etc. And the view from the top of the fort was breathtaking, as we were greeted with a spectacular view of the Hunza River and the Karakoram Highway.
Okay, Lai Lai, Jun Jun.
Yeah, east to west.
But so there is a long
arm and there is
a short arm.
Yes.
Of the clock.
Oh,
so
that will be
a little bit down there.
Better is this roof. Prayer hall.
A prayer.
Mosque. So when Islam arrived here, So this is the first mosque here in the valley. So
now we are going to the royal kitchen.
Madam, you can come.
So this is the conference hall and cooking also here, but that time no material used the stone. The local stone, his name is Kurkur, Baloshda, in Hunza language. In Hunza, three languages. Lower Hunza Shuna and Central Rushaski and Upper Hunza Waki. Totally different languages. So fire here, smoke going upper side and ventilation coming this side, circulation. So the storage box inside, two portions, wheat storage inside. And the corner is the cold storage, with tables, potatoes, apples, storage inside. That I use the fridge.
Fridge,
yes.
There was chiller.
Chiller.
Oh, very cold.
Yeah, and down there is the Kalin, you know, in Hunza, the animal, big animal is the yak.
Mm. It's made with walnut wood from Tibet.
It's not Tibet, that one is India.
We left the fort and headed back to Duiker to witness the stunning sunset view from the Duiker Hill. And we have arranged to stay at the Eagle Nest Hotel just a few minutes from the Duiker Hill's viewpoint. And we were so lucky to witness one of the most stunning sunset ever. The sky was flawless shade of blue. We gazed out over the vast expanse of mountains and peaks, waiting patiently for the sun's rays to transform the landscape. And then it happened. The golden light begins to spread like a carpet over the distant mountain ranges, painting everything in his path. And we managed to snap some of the best sunset photos ever we have taken.
That's a lady finger, golden pig.
The next morning, we'll leave Hunza and head to Skardu. Our adventure in northern Pakistan continue, which will be documented in the next video. Stay tuned and we'll see you soon.